Amen. Hallelujah. Welcome everyone to All for Jesus Church. It is a full gospel, non-sectarian, non-denominational church. We welcome you on our Friday worship service. Before anything else, we're going to begin our worship by having an opening song. God is so good. Amen. We worship you, Lord. We exalt your name, Lord. Adore your name, O God. We worship you, Jesus. Worship. We would like to share to all of you the testimony of our brothers and sisters, amen, in Christ. And the first testimony we have is from Sister Marie de la Serna here in New York, amen. She had a surgery last October 15 and we were praying for her, I believe 3 weeks, right, or a month already. we were praying for her, and but thank God everything went successful, amen. And when they when she had the biopsy, everything is negative. She is cancer free. Thank you, Lord. And number two, our second testimony is also from Pastor Mel Ateneo from Philippines, amen. She's a pastor of a church. She's a wife of a pastor in a church in Angona, Rizal, Philippines. And thank God she is now healed. She already recovered from coronavirus. Amen. Thank God. Praise the Lord. God is truly good. God can do miracles. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. Let's praise His name and let's sing, "This is the day that the Lord has made." Amen. Praise God. Jesus, we worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh. May I call my mom for our tithes and offering message, praise God.
Praise God, hallelujah. Let's open our Bible on Luke chapter 6, verse 48. Give, and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your bosom. For with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. Hallelujah. Jesus telling us to give. Jesus called us to give into His kingdom. And the Lord asked to us to give us, hallelujah, telling us that when we give, it's come from our hearts and by faith. When by giving and without our faith, it's nothing. There's no, and we pray that the Lord will bless us what we give, and also measure what we give also. So brothers and sisters, give with all your heart, because He's our provider. Is everything. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Lord, thank you for this day, Lord God. Thank you for your words. Truly, God, apart from you, we can do nothing. We continue to pray for our tithes and offering. Lord, we pray that you're going to bless us. Lord, we pray that, Lord God, hallelujah, that you're going, Father, that you open your supernatural increase in our lives. And our provision in our lives, Lord Jesus. We pray that you're going to be with us, and we believe, Lord God, that your promises to us is always true, Lord God, that you're going to bless us. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord God. We bring back the glory in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Truly, that giving to God needs to have a cheerful heart, and it's a act of worship. Amen. Praise God. Without further ado, I'm going now to call the man of God. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Pastor Isaiah Sangguan. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. And good evening to in the Philippines, and welcome to All for Jesus Church. As we gather here again today, we thank the Lord for giving us again the opportunity to spread His holy words. Amen. But before that, let us pray. Father in heaven, in the name of Jesus, we come to you today, Lord. This is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank the Father for this opportunity that you have given unto us to spread thy words, Lord. Let your Holy Spirit be upon us, Lord. Let your Holy Spirit be upon those who listen to your words right now, Lord. And manifest these words in their life, Lord, as well as in their hearts. Amen. Let them, Lord, let us be the doer of your words. Not only the listener of your words, but the doer of your words. We thank the Father for all the blessings that you have given unto us. For the whole week, Lord, we thank you for your guidance and protection. And we thank you for our lives, Lord, that you have given us a new hope and a new blessings, Lord, that comes from you. We thank you, Father, for this day, and bless each and every one of us who listens to your words, Lord. And be with us, Lord. Hide me behind your back, Lord. Let your glory be seen in this place, Lord. And let your glory be seen to all who follow you, Lord. We praise your name. We thank the Father in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Our topic for today, brothers and sisters, is found in the book of Malachi 3, verse 1 to 18. You can read that in your home, Malachi 3, verse 1 to 18. God accepts and secures anyone who earnestly returns to Him. Amen.
Amen.
God, since the creation of man, has never kept a man ignorant of his will for all. Amen. Even when a man goes astray or lost, he will seek his return to Him, because it is really not His will, amen, that anyone should perish, but get repented. Man has always wanted to go in his own way, amen, his own will. But God always desires to put all possible means to bring him back to the way of life. So many ways which seem right to the man are destructive at the end. Amen. In Proverbs 14, 12, it says there's a way that seems right to a man, but in the end, it leads to death. Amen. Maganda sa tingin sa una, pero sa dulo, kapahamakan pala. Amen. Israel, as a nation, and all spiritual Israelites by rebirth, have always been given this kind-hearted call from our Lord. The Lord said, return unto me, and I will return to you. It says there in Malachi 3, verse 7, letter B. A good knowledge and a good regard to his strong and blazing call gives peace and abundant life. No matter the level or gravity of man's sins, maski anong antas o bigat ng kasalanan ng tao, God is always able and willing to set him free by cleansing him of them all. Amen. If a censor intention and action is exhibited and exposed by the sinner. Amen. In Isaiah 1, verse 18, this verse, in fact, is God is inviting everyone who had sinned. Amen. Prophet Malachi was used at that time when the Israelites were caught in the web of ungodliness. They have put off and removed the word of God. Amen. They disregard the command of God. At that time, they even had deceivers bearing big status and monikers in God's house, but telling them lies in the form of messages. Then to hear and not the truth from the Almighty God. Similarly, among religious leaders of today are some lying prophets. Amen. Sinungaling na mga propeta, prophesying nonsense events. They're too good to be true. But there are still remnants of the prophet Elijah who will not bow down to Baal. They are rather busy telling us the truth from God to enable us to retrace our feet from where we fell. Amen. Dapat malaman natin kung saan tayo nagkamali. Amen. This lesson presents a good chance of retreating back to the way, that narrow way back to the God. Amen. That narrow way back to God. Amen. Very narrow, amen. Such that one make it to heaven. If the individual remains in faith till the end, the entire people of Israel in the days of Malachi, there is no doubt they have gone astray from the way of the Lord and followed their own way, contrary to the will of God. They failed to see God as their maker, amen, who deserves all the honor. They can give him. The priest before failed to teach the people the truth from the word of God. The priest before, whose devotedness for godliness had dwindled and dropped, amen. So no reason to make enough aspiring effort to enable them to know the truth. That sets free and restores godly living. The eventuality were that no one was interested in seeking the truth. Amen. They all disrespected the Creator, which is our God, and worship the creatures they had. Amen. Hindi na yung Creator ang sinasamba, kundi yung nilalang ng Creator. Amen. Yung linalang ng Creator ang sinasamba, the creation. Pati gagamba, pati ahas, pati mga litrato na hindi nila kilala kung sino-sino. They put good secondary, they put good God secondary instead in the right place as the real Father. Pangalawa na lamang si Jesus, amen. Pangalawa na lamang ang ating Diyos sa kanila. They neglected God and His house. Pati church, pinabayana ang gawain nila sa Diyos. They failed to fear and worship God in sincerity and in truth. They gave unworthy offering to God as if God was a beggar. Inaakala nila ang Diyos ay pulubi. Yung tira-tira lamang ang i-offering nila sa Diyos na para siyang pulubi. They failed to pay complete tithes. Amen. This is the important of tithing. Dinadaya pa nila ang Diyos. Amen. They live in comfortable house. They live in comfortable houses. Nakatira sila sa magagarang bahay. But neglect the place where God is worshipped. Amen. Amen. Pinabayaan na yung bahay parambahan because of their wavering and indecisiveness to build them their convenience. That never came. Nadrawing lang. Amen. Nadrawing lang. In those days, the synagogues, their churches before, were neglected and abandoned because people are not committed and sincere in doing so. Amen. So in these last days, nowadays, these days now, people are after their own personal enrichment or self-enrichment. Amen. Yan ang inaato Panginoon ng mga church leaders, yung magpapayaman. Amen. Some have left God. Pati Diyos, iniwaran na rin nila. Sasabi nila, ayaw na namin. Today, some who care to teach select their types of teachings only, which only make their followers to be happy. Amen. Yung pastor nila, piling-pili yung isinisermon. Simulat sa Paul, 3 taon na, patawa lang ang kanyang isinisermon. Amen. Patawa ng patawa. Even when they know they cannot make it to heaven as they are, they are not bothered. Hindi sila nag-alala. As far as they can flow in their happiness and enjoyment in ungodly and conflicts joy, wala silang problema. Amen. Many prophets of old prophesied to gain fame. Amen. Some accepted and admired Baal. The idol god, this Baal, is the idol god during the reign of the wicked couple, King Ahab and his wife Jezebel. 1 Kings 16 verse 29. Having lost the Spirit of God, they followed and worshiped Baal. Some also bribe yung suhol to speak contrary to God's word. Yung iba tumanggap ng suhol para magpahayag ng salita laban sa Diyos. Some pastors of our days has been distracted and disorganized, focusing on the Lord. Nawala na yung konsentrasyon nila para sa Panginoon. Many have left teaching. Iniwanan na yung pagtuturo ng salita ng Diyos and make repeatable quotes to encourage their flesh and in delight remain as a member of their church group. Hindi na Word of God ang itinuturo yung mga kabalbalan na, amen? At tuwang-tuwa din itong mga members ng church na ito. Even when the preachers know their hopeless spiritual bankrupt state, maski alam ng pastor na bangkarote na ang mga buhay spiritual nila, baliwala pa rin ito pa sa kanila. Disobedience of the Word of God is even worse off in our time. Amen? Yes. Among the leaders, ang pagsuway sa Diyos ay mas masahol sa ngayon. The believer's primary affection and obedience should be on the Lord, not to the man. Amen?
Amen.
Regardless of his title, maski sino siya, position or possession, an example is in the dressing style. One example is in the dressing style of some church members. Amen? The dressing style of church members. Use formal dress when you go to the church. Amen? Formal dress as a respect to our God. Huwag naman yung magsuot ng miniskirt. Litaw pa yung pusod na may hikaw. Amen? Butas-butas pa yung pantalon. But the most painful is that some pastors are in support of this shame. Amen? Ang masama nito, pati pastor kinikilig. Some intelligent ones, yung mga matatalino, even see half-naked type of dressing as proof of exposure. Not minding the effect of the people around them, they don't mind. Attempting to correct them brings one to laughter. They enjoy it seeing anyway. Amen? Another one is about the tithes and offering. This is the most important, one of the most important thing in worshiping the Lord. Tithes and offering. Tithes is one-tenth. The 10% of the person's total
salary,
income.
Amen.
That should be paid into the Lord's house. Amen?
Amen?
Offering, on the other hand, is anything or amount one gives cheerfully to the Lord, according to one's enablement or simplification. It should be given generously and free-heartedly unto the Lord. The reason, to attract blessings from Him, amen? To attract blessings from the Lord. That's all you need. That's all we need, to attract blessings from the Lord. Because God is the giver of all good things in life. Amen?
Amen.
Kung mahusay tayong mag-drama, no? Kung humingi, kailangan marunong din tayo magbigay sa Kanya. Amen?
Amen?
What are the blessings of paying tithes and giving offerings? In Malachi 3:10 verse 11, God said, "Bring the whole tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so many blessings that you will not have room enough for it." In verse 11, "I will prevent pest from devouring your crops, and the vines of your fields will not cast their fruits, says the Lord Almighty." God does not give for our earthly usage, amen, but also eternal things. Hindi lang siya nagbibigay para dito sa lupa. Nagbibigay din siya para sa buhay na walang hanggan. Amen?
Amen.
How should we return unto God? How should we return unto God? In Isaiah 1 verse 18, it says there, "Come now, come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Through your sins are like scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they are red as crimson, they shall be like wool." There is no greater invitation found in the Bible than this one, given by the Holy Spirit through the prophet Isaiah. In this passage, sins are spoken as scarlet, amen, such as a reference of blood, guiltiness. All sin is murder in some form. As a result, the blood guiltiness. This glorious passage illustrates to us the eternal truth that regardless of the evil, wickedness, deception, and weight of sin, yung bigat ng kasalanan, the Lord stands ready,
yes,
upon proper confession, amen?
Amen,
and repentance to forgive all and therefore to cleanse all. In 1 John 1:9, this is done exclusively by faith in Christ and His shed blood. Ephesians 2 verse 13 to 18 and Isaiah 1 verse 19. This is the promise of the Lord in Isaiah 1 verse 19. If you are willing and obedient, you will eat the best or the good of the land. Amen. The eating of the best of the or good of the land. The idea is that God controls all. Amen.
Yes.
If we obey Him, okay, God controls it, controls all. If we obey Him, blessings will be ours. Blessings will be ours. If we do not obey, if we do not obey Him, He will allow enemies to come in and destroy and ravage completely. Amen. The Lord does not despise or hamakin or hate or galit a repentant heart. Amen. What He wants sinners to return to Him.
Amen.
For forgiveness and re-enter into the sheepfold or the enclosure. Amen. For one to return to the Lord, he has to realize himself by identifying his real sinful spiritual state, like the prodigal son. Amen. Remember the prodigal son? He needs to tell himself the truth regarding his insecure, ungodly state. And he needs to make a solution to set right, to come back to God. Amen.
Yes.
Who forgives at any time. He's just waiting for us to go near to Him. Amen.
Amen.
He's just waiting for you, brothers. He's just waiting for you, sister. Since return and repentance to God, to our God, will bring about the following. These are the following. There is a joy in heaven. Amen.
Amen.
Thousands of angels will be rejoicing. Amen. The repentant sinner's name gets written in the book of life. Amen. And he now has the peace of God. Letter B, the individual has grace to live a victorious Christian life on earth. Amen. And has hope of eternal life. Amen. You have hope in the of eternal life. God always makes provision for salvation and for backslider to return again. Amen. That means you still have the chance to return to God. Amen. You have a lot of time to return to God, because He is not willing that any soul should perish. He doesn't want that. It will be too painful and sorrowful for one to deliberately remain insane. Amen? Yung patuloy na nagkakasala, ignoring and disregarding the grace available for his redemption, and still go on to hell. Amen? Babalik, pupunta ka sa impyerno. Amen? Sa impyerno pa rin ang bagsak mo, kapatid. Once we hear his voice, once we hear his voice, we should not harden our hearts. Amen?
Amen.
But humble ourselves in repentance that warrants salvation. That's the warrant of salvation. Humble ourselves in repentance. Anyone who abuses the grace of God, listen to this, anyone who abuses the grace of God, amen, suffers condemnation, having thrown away God's provision for eternal life. Amen. Have you taken advantage of the rare, this rare privilege to return to God from your sinful state? Well, do it now and quickly. One possession, katayuan, title of designation, and family background is not important to this matter. Amen? Wala lahat yan, but a humble, earnest search for godliness. Accountability is required. Amen? Kailangan of every one of us someday. Someday. It is only a genuine and sincere heart, sincere return to the Lord and stay with Him in righteousness that can prove man a place in the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
In Revelation 2 verse 4, Jesus said, "Yet I hold this against you. You have forsaken your first love." Amen.
Amen.
Your first love should be Jesus Christ. Amen.
Yes.
Therefore,
yes,
let us come back to our first love for God. Amen.
Amen.
In all our ways, daily, that means every day, avail yourself of this opportunity and return to the open and forgiving hands of our Maker. Amen. And start enjoy the abundant life in Christ with the greatest and unequal peace that comes along with it. Amen?
Amen.
The greatest and unequal peace that comes along with it as evidence to smile all your life. Amen? Lagi nakangiti kasi masaya ang buhay kung lagi kay Kristo. To God be the glory.
Amen.
Father in heaven, in the name of Jesus, we thank the Father for this, for your words. Show us, Lord, how to reach your kingdom, Lord. Guide us, Lord, in our everyday life. We want to return to you, Lord. Some our brethren, Lord, wants to return to you.
Amen.
And I know, Lord, that you will accept them. You will accept them with them, with your open arms.
Yes, Lord.
As you forgive our sins, Lord. You are faithful and just to forgive our sins and purify us unto all unrighteousness.
Yes.
We thank you for your promise in 1 John 1:9, Lord. We thank you, Lord. And I know, Lord, that you have already forgiven our sins.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. We bring back all the glory and all the honor in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. What a wonderful message. To recap our message for today is that we have to make sure, double check ourselves before the Lord. Amen. That whatever we are doing, hallelujah, should always bring back the glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. And now is the time of repentance. Amen. Anything that is hidden in our hearts, or anything that is not pleasing the Lord, we have to give it to God and ask for forgiveness. If you want to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior, please follow this prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit, We come before you. I acknowledge, Lord God, that I am a sinner. Amen. And I'm asking you to forgive me for all my sins. Amen. Help me, Jesus, and wash away all my sins, Lord God. Lord, thank you, Lord, for this time, Lord, for this day, that you have given me an opportunity to come before you. And I accept you, Jesus, as my Lord and my Savior. Come into my heart, come into my life, and be my Lord, my Savior, be my Master in my life. Lord, thank you, Jesus, for this new life. Thank you for carving my name in the book of life. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. I'm calling now the praise and worship team to sing our victory song. In the name of Jesus, amen, there is always a victory. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. May the peace and the love of God be upon us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, brothers and sisters. God bless.